Hey guys, BoSchitt here, and I'd like to welcome you to a small portion of the channel known as the BoSchitt vlog. I didn't hope to do a lot of these because I know that's not what you guys come for, but I felt it was necessary considering not a lot of people really read the blog over the years. Those who did, though, thank you very much. That was, you guys were the ones that were keeping in touch with everything. The other is, of course, just in general, I haven't been doing a very good job of communicating with the community. A lot of rumors spread, a lot of people thought, you know, I was dead, I stopped making videos, stuff like that, and I blame myself because I hadn't really done a lot of communicating with the community, and I think this would be the perfect opportunity to start doing that now. The format is simple. I talk and I just kind of play a game or a behind-the-scenes footage thing in the background for you to watch while I blabber on. I hope not to do too many of these because this is not the kind of content you expect from me, so only when I feel something needs to be said or a soapbox kind of issue comes up, then yeah, I'll do a couple of these. But for now, I'd really like to put, I want to say 80% of the focus on other projects, Gmod projects in general, maybe Source Filmmaker. The topic of Source Filmmaker is kind of a big one right now, so I'd like to dedicate an entire vlog to that one later on down the line. When I get a chance, there is a lot that needs to be said, so we'll get to that later. Alright, well, enough of the introductory stuff. I'd like to keep these vlogs under 10 minutes, so let's get started on one of the big issues that has happened over the past couple of months now. The first, of course, being the big burning question, where the hell have you been the past couple of months? What have you been doing? Well, those of you who follow me on Twitter, the link is in the video description for anybody who wants to follow me there. The Twitter followers already know that I have made a big move within the last couple of months from Washington State to Arkansas. The location wasn't exactly my choice, but you know, personal reasons come up and everything just kind of comes together, and I had friends here, so here we are. Now, culture shock aside, the job that I was settling into was off to a kind of a bad start, to say the least. The hours were pretty constant. I was working 54 hours minimum, I believe, and the schedule was never consistent, so it was really difficult to really have any time to myself, and that's why there were no uploads for months on end. However, at the time, I still was working on a Gmod video. You've no doubt seen it by now, the Duke Nukem Forever Quest video, which actually wound up being a bigger project than I thought, and the best I could do was really chip away at it in the small time I had at home. So that pretty much explains it, why it was taking so long to get anything done. Now, speaking of jobs, I think this would go ahead and bring us right into our next topic of interest, and that is the growing number of ads on each of my videos. Now, I've said in the past that I've turned down a number of revenue sharing, partnership opportunities that have been offered to me, and a lot of that was because with those opportunities came a lot of restrictions on your content. What you can parody, what you can and cannot say, who you can't make fun of, that sort of thing. It didn't bother me too much to do a lot of free videos because at the time I guess I didn't really need the money. I was in a decent place. I had a pretty steady job with a pretty steady schedule and everything worked out alright. But when I had to move and I had to go to Arkansas, let's face it, there's not a lot of money in Arkansas. I was quickly realizing that all of the money that I was making at work was pretty much all going to bills, food, and gas. It was getting ridiculous. I started thinking to myself, you know, what happens if medical emergencies come up? What if my car breaks down? What if I crash the damn thing? What if my computer breaks? I wouldn't be able to pay for any of that stuff for a good long while. It was to the point where I was starting to have to think about getting a second job. And you know what that would have meant. No more videos. There would be no time. I would have no drive. I would come home exhausted. I wouldn't want to work on something again when I got home. Well, thankfully, about a month or two ago, the Game Station came to me and they gave me an offer to join up in their network. And I've actually been quite a follower of the Game Station. I've watched people like Total Biscuit, Jesse Cox, the Yogg's Cast, Kraken. So not only was the familiarity there, what really got my attention is the fact that the creative freedoms had much, much less restrictions than previous offers that I've been given. I mean, sure, there will always be some, but these were manageable. I was actually able to make videos with very few changes. So I was on board. I went ahead and I signed right up and I decided to make videos my second job. And I think in that way, everybody wins. I can continue to do what I enjoy doing, and I can still provide content for you guys. So as a result of this being a second job, you're probably going to see a lot more frequent uploads. I'll try and make sure I don't upload a lot of junk content, like too many vlogs or too many tiny little videos or test videos. Nobody comes for that. I'm going to try and keep my content consistent with the stuff that I've been making for the past 3 years. Now, that doesn't change the fact that the Idiot Box series takes a while to make. I'm definitely going to continue that, but what I do want to do is do a couple of shorts in between those larger projects and everything to be topical, and because they're just easier to make, the shorter ones between the 2 or 3 minute mark. So I'd like to try and do that a bit more in between the large projects, so no worries there. All right, one last thing before I wrap this up. I wanted to make a quick apology about the fiasco surrounding my entry to the Castle Calamity collaboration. Now, for those of you who were complaining about the length of the video,
stop whining!
The conditions on your entry to the collaboration were 5 to 15 seconds long. This wasn't my own project, this was my entry to a collaboration. That's not what I'm apologizing for. What I am apologizing for is the fact that there was an ad on the video, and I didn't mean for that to happen, especially to make that video loop and have the ad loop over and over again, which is what I've been hearing about in the comments. The reason that happened is because the game station automatically begins monetizing a video whether you have chosen to do it or not, and that's to make sure that everybody didn't lose out on money if they forgot to monetize. So I just figured out about the whitelisting feature, and there's just a small process in doing that. I didn't know that at the time, but I do now, so hopefully we can avoid things like that. I'm just trying to figure out the ins and outs of the game station at the moment, so please be patient, and I do apologize for that. Alright, well, I think that about does it for the first BoSchitt vlog. I hope to start tackling a couple of other rumors and soapbox issues that need to come up. The first, of course, being Source Filmmaker. I have been asked about Source Filmmaker so much, as well as many other people who have started Gmod movies. Many say Source Filmmaker is the Gmod killer, and I tend to disagree quite a bit about that, but that's a topic for another time. The other is bronies. I know, I've made a blog post about this. I'll probably be repeating myself a few times, but it needs to be addressed. The comments on each video are getting out of hand, so we'll talk about this as well some other time. Alright guys, thanks for joining me on the first ever vlog. I hope you will enjoy the next few projects coming your way, and I'll see you next time.